The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by Dana Brooke from Stone Mountain, Georgia, weighing in at 240 pounds, Apollo Crews.
And there he is, Apollo Crews on the way to the ring.
The Raw crowd here tonight is definitely fired up for this one.
Tampa, Florida, weighing in at 270 pounds, Titus O'Neil.
Four of WWE's finest squaring off in what will assuredly be an exciting tag team encounter. I don't recall the last time I've been this excited for a Raw match. Oh man, this is gonna be great.
And their opponents, first, from Lucerne, Switzerland, weighing in at 232 pounds, one half of the World Tag Team Champion. And his partner, from Dublin, Ireland, weighing in at 267 pounds, one half of the World Tag Team Champions, the Celtic Warrior, Sheamus!
Oh, the referee will undoubtedly have his hands full when these two teams collide. These teams looking to make a mark here in the tag team division.
Both legal men are in the ring and set to start things off here. We're ready to go.
I want to point out, it's important to mesh with your partner in a tag match. You don't necessarily have to like them, but if you're not on the same page, you're probably going to lose.
This is going to be a hell of a match, boys.
But I know this, the fans of the WWE, both here and at home, are all fired up for this one.
Here's Crews with some offense of his own.
Devastating maneuver.
Guys, let's quickly discuss Apollo Crews.
It's a tag team match, so the parts are sometimes greater than the whole. What can we expect here?
He and his partner look good so far, Michael, but it's far too early to pick a winner. Let's see how this one plays out.
Hey, some guys work better when somebody else is doing the administrative end of the business. He's clearly one of those guys.
That man.
may be the first time we've seen that executed.
He's not looking like himself here.
This tag team match can get out of hand quickly if he doesn't mount an offense soon.
Come on, if he can't withstand this, he's in the wrong profession.
I don't disagree. And one thing I'll never do is count this guy out.
Well, I've never seen him do that before. Sheamus is a superstar who's broken a lot of barriers and a lot of skulls, King, but the one barrier he's proudest of breaking is being the first Irish-born champion in WWE history.
Well, that's right, Cole. The Celtic Warrior came straight from the old country holding a big old four-leaf clover. But there was no luck involved the way Sheamus won his first title. It was pure guts. He took the championship off none other than John Cena at Tables, Ladders, and Chairs in his rookie year in 2009. Now that was as quick a climb to the top of WWE as you're gonna see.
Well, well, well. That's the first time tonight we've seen that move.
I wouldn't mind seeing it a little more often.
As prestigious and groundbreaking as that first WWE championship may have been for Sheamus, his World Heavyweight Championship win in 2012 was no less of an achievement. It came on the grandest stage of them all at WrestleMania 28 against Daniel Bryan. If Sheamus' first title gave him a place on the map, that second one gave him his own area code, just making his presence felt there.
This guy doesn't need a therapist. What he needs is an exorcist. And you talk about Sheamus' World Heavyweight Championship at WrestleMania 28. What made that win over Daniel Bryan even more momentous was the fact that the Celtic Warrior did it in an unbelievable 18 seconds. I mean, Sheamus won the title in less time than it takes you, Cole, to put on your socks in the morning.
He's taking some offense. Headed into this match, he and his partner look extremely confident.
Well, if he can't bounce back from this, then maybe he's not as tough as I thought he was.
Agreed. And you have to wonder where this guy's confidence level is at this point. Oh, the Celtic Warrior Sheamus is one of the most intense WWE superstars you'll ever see in a ring. His fiery temper and love of a good fight means he's not backing down from anyone. And he's always just one bro kick away from victory.
Look out. Titus O'Neil is measuring. Two. It starts to feel like a broken record with that move. He looks a bit off his game here. And you have to assume his partner is just itching to get in there right about now.
Look at this guy. He's better than what we're seeing right now.
It's a good point, John. And I'd say this match is about as even as it can get at this point. Cesaro has found an answer here.
Here's a cover.
O'Neal reverses it. And it's Cesaro executing the reversal.
Certainly showing us something new from his repertoire.
That's cool. I like new stuff. Oh, what a suplex. This guy has strength, that's for sure.
There may be no stopping him.
Hoping to get out of here early with a win.
And again, the mind games are played. And he rolls out, buying himself some breathing room.
Careful what you wish for. It can get real ugly outside the ring.
And these guys are real ugly. What should Titus O'Neil try to do differently at this stage to remain viable? Rather than continuing to absorb any more punishment, he might want to tag out here.
And Michael, if what we've seen so far is any indication of what's to come, I fully expect him to go for that finisher again the next time he sees an opening.
Well, he respects himself and this business too much to give up now, Cole. I think this one's still far from over.
Good Lord, that wasn't even close.
So that's what it's like being so far off the mark.
And he's heading back in.
I can't blame him.
Trying to get under his opponents.
My God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
And I hope we can get a doctor out here as a precaution. Damaged ribs like that can make it hard to breathe.
Just with the punishment that's been...
They did it! They won the match!
Here are your winners, Cesaro and the Celtic Warrior, Sheamus!
I love a good tag team match, and this one was unforgettable. I mean, these teams gave us everything they had, and the WWE Universe is the true winner in this one.
And don't forget, you and I, we have the best seats in the house.
I don't think Titus O'Neil is used to losing like that. Wow. With that win in the books, we must now move on.